Welcome to The Music Reel. I'm your host, Nicola Burton. I have with me Manny Kirikidis from the Pushworth Group. And today our very special guest is a gentleman by the name of Samwise Holmes, and he is from Action Reaction Entertainment. Now, this is a company that's been specializing in action, acrobatic, stunt, comedy shows, as well as action experiences, etc. But thanks to the lockdown impact on the music industry, Action Reaction Entertainment is actually bringing live entertainment back sooner than most other people with something quite unique, with Australia's first drive-in live music shows. Samwise, welcome to the Music Reel conversation. How are you today?
I'm doing so great. How are you?
Really good, considering this crazy place that we find ourselves in 2020.
Yes.
So obviously, like hundreds of thousands of other music industry workers, you would have found yourself in a very strange place in March with very little live income. But instead of just sitting back going, oh, well, that's how it is, you've leveled up and come up with this drive-in concept. So can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, of course. So yeah, towards the end of March, when everything shut down, our entire business shut down as well. All of our entertainers out of work, same with the rest of the entertainment industry. And so drive-in entertainment was something that we thought of, you know, just an expansion on the drive-in cinema notion. But for live entertainment, why can't we do that with a stage? And so we drafted the idea back in March, and we sort of worked on it. We had our big launch event in May with Casey Donovan, and that was a huge success. And we used that to test the model, see if there were going to be any logistical issues, all of that. Fortunately, it all went really smooth, and it even rained and showed us that the event works really well, even if it's raining. which sounds like an awful thing, but for the context there, it was actually quite helpful for us. So yeah, we're launching a series of drive-in events, not just concerts, but comedy, music theatre, children's entertainment. There's a variety of entertainment options that will be sort of available there. But yeah, we're taking it around the country and bringing that entertainment back to not just the workers in the Australian arts community, but back to the community that are looking for some kind of reprieve from their lockdown and their social distancing.
Now, it's fantastic because all of us remember, you know, as kids being bundled into the back of the car and someone's hiding under the blanket so that they don't have to take, you know, the drive, that we all did that. So it's really nice to have this concept being reintroduced to the Australian entertainment market. Well done, dude. Now, Manny,
thank you so much.
I might bring you in, Manny. You've probably got some questions for Sam.
Oh, I do have a myriad of questions, but I'll sort of narrow it down because we've got some time frame, you know, constraints for obvious reasons. Innovation is the mother of all creation, Samwise. So congratulations to you and yours. They're absolutely brilliant. And you were the first to get out there. But we're also hearing about some other interesting and other innovative ideas as well. So we're an industry that, whilst we are challenged, we have some very creative types that come up with some interesting concepts. So I guess the drive-in, and I'm really chomping at the bit to hear who you've got on, you know, being that we're in the music industry, we're all music fans, and so we're chomping at the bit to hear the lineups. But I guess from a technical point of view, I guess you've got a PA system sitting out the front there as well. How do you interface that with the car stereos? I'm really curious about how you're interfacing with, is it all on FM band? Can it come through AM band? Or are you using the drive-in speakers themselves? That's from someone who loves the technology of the industry. I'd love to hear from you.
Yeah, it is an FM broadcast straight into the vehicles, and it is exclusively an FM broadcast. So there will be a station that all of the patrons are given when they enter, and we feed this straight from the desk. So everything that comes through the from the stage, everything that would normally be coming through the speakers at the front of the stage and will still be coming from a front of house system will also come through that FM broadcast. So we've got a broadcaster which will be sitting up somewhere high and broadcasting that out just to our sort of our area, and yeah, you can tune into that channel, and it's as simple as that.
That's brilliant. So absolutely.
What about logistically? I guess I'm going to ask really basic questions, like going to the bathroom, Do people bring their own food? Do you have food being sold there? All those traditional things that you deal with at a drive-in, how do you deal with that differently now?
Yeah, of course. So we provide everyone a bottle on entry where they can go to the bathroom in. I'm kidding. We don't. We give everybody. everyone can leave the vehicle and go to the bathroom. That is the one exception by which you can exit your vehicle is to go to the bathroom. And if these restrictions ease even further, then we will open up the ability for people to get out of their cars for other reasons as well, if everything was to sort of become safe again. But that's for another time. Right now, we're focusing on keeping everyone safe and in their cars unless they need to pee.
Now, that's great. Now, how can artists get involved with this concept? And I'm assuming it's all around Australia?
That's right. So we're going to be launching in Sydney and we're going to be in Brisbane. We're going to be in Canberra and we're going to be in Melbourne as well over the coming months. So we've got a range of well-known acts as well as local artists. And we've put out call outs for local artists, at least for the first location, which will be in Sydney, so that local artists can put their name in the ring as both support acts and as main acts for the event.
Okay, that sounds really good. You're going to be inundated after this interview. I'm just warning you. But look, what have you got coming up that you would really like to talk about?
So we've got a really exciting lineup for the first weekend. So we've got fantastic children's entertainment opening the first day with the Wiggles coming in for their first concerts in a little while, doing three shows on Friday the 17th, followed by a spectacular concert from the Veronicas in the evening. And then an after party with DJ Dan Murphy, who many people know from his big raves over at the Ivy.
Wow. So I'm interested to see how parents are going to control their kids in the car with the Wiggles concert. That's going to be interesting.
Oh, we've got some great ideas for there. But even more spectacularly, the Wiggles will be showing up in their big red car, which is just perfect.
This just sounds fantastic, Samwise. We wish you the very best for this, not just during lockdown, but I think as restrictions ease and we get back to whatever normal is, it'll be great to see this concept evolve. I think it's a great new twist. And look, we've been pretty bored with doing the same old, so it's great to hear of something new. So Samwise Holmes, thank you for chatting with us today. Thank you for joining the conversation. We wish you the best. And please, we're going to stay in touch with you to see how this pans out over the next few months. So thank you so much and take care. We will talk to you very soon.
Thank you so much for having me. Have a great afternoon.
Thanks, Sam. Yeah.